Hello friends, today's project is cooler pump safety. Coolers are used in many houses to get relief from summers, but it is seen that cooler pumps wear and tear soon. The reason behind this is that the cooler pump keeps on running even if the tank is empty. Using this simple circuit, you can save your cooler pump in two ways. One is the cooler pump is turned off if the water is finished in the tank. And second is the cooler pump will not run for full time. It will be on for 4 to 4.5 minutes and off for 2 to 2.5 minutes. This way, the cooler pump will work more efficiently and provide proper coolness. Let us take a look at the component list to develop this project. You can also see all the components from the circuit diagram. First, in the left hand side is a transformer. Then a bridge rectifier. For power supply, we have used LM7805 voltage regulator. After this, you will see 555 IC. And next is the decade counter IC4017. One transistor 2N2219 to drive a relay. And a relay to connect with the cooler pump. Apart from these components, we need some resistors, capacitors, jumper wires and a breadboard. This is our assembled circuit on a breadboard. We have taken common positives and negatives from here. We have given the power supply to this breadboard from here. This is 555 IC. This IC is used to provide clock to your circuit. To pin number 3 of it, we have added one LED for representation of the clock. Clock is developed at pin 3. We want our 555 timer to work as a stable multi-vibrator to generate clock. For that purpose, connect two resistors to pin number 7, short pin 6 and 2 and connect a capacitor to it. This makes our 555 timer work as a stable multi-vibrator and creates a clock at pin number 3. We have used this clock for a decade counter 4017. It has 10 outputs, but we have used only Q7, Q8 and Q9. We have connected these outputs to the diodes and shorted them at output for turning on and off of the relay. Or you can say cooler pump. We have used this decade counter for managing on and off timings of our cooler pump. This transistor is taking input from the decade counter and is used here to drive the relay. We have used a relay here in the prototype and use this LED as indication for turning on and off of the cooler pump. You have to connect this to the cooler motor on installing this with the cooler. For testing, we have taken some water in a bucket and immersed the water level sensor in that water. When there is a water in a cooler, the decade counter will get its clock and circuit is functional. You can see this LED is on when water is in the bucket. Short pin 13 and pin 15 of decade counter and connect this water level sensor to it. Immerse the other end of the wire with metal into the cooler tank. You can see the same in the circuit diagram. When water is there in the tank, the circuit will complete and pin 15 and 13 are grounded and the circuit is enabled. When there is no water, it is an open circuit. Then pin 13 and 15 both are high. Decade counter will get clock from 555 timer. But there will be no increment in clock and circuit will stop and motor will turn off. This is our prototype. For installing it to the cooler, put this water sensor into the water tank and connect this side with the cooler pump in place of this relay. After installing the circuit, provide a power supply to it. Here we have used a low value capacitor in our prototype. You have to use the same value capacitor provided in the circuit diagram while installing the circuit to your cooler. Now our next point is how the cooler pump is turning on and off for a specific time interval. This time is decided by the formula 0.693 into R2 plus R3 into C2. You can see the values of R2, R3 and C2 in the circuit diagram and in the component list. It will come out to be approximately 40 seconds. That means the cooler pump will be on for approximately 40 seconds and off for 22 seconds. The circuit will reset once the tank is empty and the cooler pump is turned off. You can make this circuit on a PCB and assemble it in a box for installing it with your cooler. This is a very useful and simple circuit with simple components. This is all about this project. We hope you liked it. Do implement this project at home and let us know your experience. Thank you.